Hi there, let's look at data types. So for this video, you'll be learning on how to declare different data types such as integer, real, char, string, boolean, date when writing pseudocode. First of all, when writing pseudocode, your algorithm, you need to make clear the data type intended for all identifiers used. A declare pseudocode statement is used and this is called a declaration statement. So let's look at this. Declare identifier data type. Identifier is just a name, so just think it like a variable name. And data type is just a data type. So how you write declare pseudocode statement is that declare space identifier space colon space data type. So this is how you can declare a data type with the identifier name. Now let's look at one example. Declare my birthday date. It means that the identifier name is my birthday and the data type is date. Since we don't put space when we declare the identifier, therefore the M here and the B here will be capital. So this is how you can declare the identifier without a space. And pseudocode will contain following data types such as integer, real, char, string, boolean, date, array, and file. So for this video itself, we'll be covering the first 6 data types and the last 2 data types we'll cover in the future video. Now let's look at integer and real. So first of all, what is integer? Integer is a whole number, positive or negative, no fractional part. It means that there's no decimal point, there's no fraction for integer. To declare integer, we will write declare mileage integer. So declare space mileage space colon space integer. So this is how you can declare integer. Next will be real. Real is a number that has a fractional part. It means that it has a decimal point. To declare, we will write declare average monthly budget real. So it means that this average monthly budget can be written with decimal point. And next will be char and string. So first of all, what is char? Char is a single character. It can be any letter, number, punctuation, or space. For example, gender M for male, F for female. So just be careful that when we are declaring char in pseudocode, we always use single quotation. So let's look at this. Single quotation, capital M, single quotation. And for F, single quotation, capital F, and single quotation. We will write declare gender char. It means that gender is the identifier name and char is the data type. Also a gender reminder that when we are writing data type, it's always in capital letter. So let's look at this. C-H-A-R. All are capital letter. Now let's look at string. So what is string? String is a sequence of alphanumerical characters enclosed in double quotation here. For example, double quotation A-B-C, double quotation. So this is how you actually assign a value. Let's look at a broader example and see how we can declare string. So first of all, we have Tom, Jerry, 12 Evelyn Gardens, SW73BG. So this is the name, this is the address, and this is the postcode. Declare client name string, and then declare address line 1 string, and finally declare address line 2 string. So this is how you declare string. Lastly, let's look at Boolean and date. So first of all, what is Boolean? Boolean is either true or false. For example, is a customer allow entry or is the vehicle text? And we can write declare entry allow Boolean and declare vehicle text Boolean. And finally, will be date. So for date, it's normally stored as a serial number such as DD slash MM slash YYYY. It means that date, month, year. Or MM slash DD slash YYYY. So the format will normally depend on the country. And definitely for this syllabus sake, we won't have to learn how to define the format. And let's look at how can we declare a date. So declare registration date. So it means that the identifier name is registration date and the data type is date. I hope you enjoyed this short series on data type. Definitely give my video a thumbs up, leave your comment, and please subscribe to the channel. Thank you, and I'll see you again then. Bye bye.